if you want to do banking in rural areas, right, technology has to be the backbone. And there are many examples where government has taken steps in terms of how do we incentivize mobile banking. The reason would be the option of 2G, where in the final, you know, into the cost of doing business, the customer, that the charge that he has to pay will finally come down. Last but not the least, in terms of how do they create a private and public partnership ecosystem. So they've been, you know, kind of ERAI and RBI, and I think they have come together and made some of the policies in this endeavor, in this direction. We have a lot of investment players who want to make investment in our kind of plan. It's just that we need to come back to them with a good plan, concrete, solid foundations so that they can show trust that we can take it to the next level. They have leverage and they have taken and done business with the urban stuff. Rural is where they want to go next. And that's very, very important for us. Private players have already understood that and they're ready to partner with the government to make it happen. From an overall government view, we need a fresh banking system. So when I say that, the rules have to be looked at, they have to be redesigned model. So this entire ecosystem, if you don't reach out to masses, if you don't make them aware, whatever policies you make, I don't think it's going to work that well. Invest heavily in telecom and equity governance. When I say that, we have to create awareness of what are the entitlements of a rural population. We need to come up with creative ways of how best can we attract, encourage, and yet make the business profitable, both from a business and from the customer side. That is what we need to be very, very focusing on. So some of the things that government and private players have come together in terms of mobile technology, in terms of backbone structure, are a step in terms of innovation that's going to help in the future, right? And cost is a very important factor here. Let's not forget. If there is a way where we can get a rural population as a part of the plan, which means while we're trying to provide a service which integrates telecom and banking, what if we get them to be part of the service provider, we train them to deliver? I think that would be a very big success in itself, versus me going and trying to force them. When you touch upon rural, whatever is taken for granted in an urban situation are all wrong. So you have to start from the front, really start laying the background and then take it.